So, have you all had your lunch? I know most of you had something common today, and it is rice. Rice is very common in Asian people's food, and because Asian people love it so much. And do you have any idea how many people in this world eat rice? 3.5 billion people. 3.5 billion people. And with this 3.5 billion, rice becomes one of the important crops in half of the world's population. But nearly the same number, 3 billion people, are suffering from hidden hunger, which is caused by the deficiency of micronutrients like iron and zinc. Now, iron is very important for transporting the oxygen from our lungs to throughout our body. And if you have a deficiency of iron, then we have anemia. And if you have anemia with some other disease like cancer or kidney disease, then it becomes a complete package for death. And on the other hand, zinc is important for immunity, and it is also important to give us the sense of taste and smell. So now you must be thinking about why I'm talking about rice, because you can get iron and zinc from other vegetables like broccoli. I don't like broccoli, but you can get it. The reason why I'm talking about rice here is most of the people who are suffering from this disease, hidden hunger, are basically belongs to the developing countries. The majority of people who are very poor in the developing countries who are suffering from hidden hunger. The importance of iron and zinc is so much in rice, since this is very cheap, right? You can produce rice very easily in fields. It's not very expensive. You can give away. When I was a kid, I used to see many poor people nearby roadside, and most of the people giving away them rice because it's very cheap, not like the vegetables. So I decided, like, why should I not work on rice to make it something like different from the natural rice which we have here? So most of the people I know in this world, they don't like the genetically modified crops. They don't like the taste of genetically modified crops. They think like somehow they will become zombies. So I made this rice with a new method in which I have mutated the random mutation I have done in the DNA of the rice. Finally, we found the mutation, some useful mutations in which the rice is taking a great amount of high iron and zinc from the soil. And then we are doing the breeding, a normal breeding process, and we are transferring these genes into a new rice variety. And once my research will be done, this rice is ready to eat. That's all. Thank you so much.